El Niño and La Niña are predictable. In fact, they're the most predictable climate phenomenon on the planet other than the normal march of the seasons. The first successful prediction of an El Niño was in 1986 by Mark Kane and his group at Lamont Doherty Earth Observatory. Now there are about 20 groups worldwide that routinely issue ENSO forecasts. The models that are used are not perfect, of course, just like weather prediction models are not perfect. But they do show skill up to about 6 to 9 months. And the source of predictability for El Niño, one important source, perhaps the most important source, lies in the slow evolution of upper ocean heat content.
The upper ocean heat content that is used for El Niño prediction is the volume of warm water in a band along the equator in the tropical Pacific Ocean. The buildup of excess heat content along the equator is a necessary precondition for El Niño to occur. You can see that the heat content in red builds up prior to all El Niños in blue over the past 30 years. When the heat content reaches a certain threshold, it significantly increases the likelihood for an El Niño to occur. Winds and currents during the El Niño event purge the excess heat to higher latitudes, which terminates the event. The time between El Niños is determined by the time to recharge, by ocean currents under strong trade wind forcing, building up the excess heat content that is necessary for initiation of another El Niño. The importance of heat content as a predictor for El Niño and La Niña is a key element of the recharge oscillator theory.
Here is the compilation of 20 groups worldwide, their forecasts for the coming seasons. This is compiled by the International Research Institute for Climate and Society. What's on this axis is the Niño 3.4 index, the sea surface temperature. Time is over here. This is the neutral zone where you'd say neither El Niño or La Niña. The forecast that was below this would be for La Niña, and the forecast above this is for El Niño.
In mid-October 2015, the forecaster consensus unanimously favored a strong El Niño.